What are you doing? Oh, I'm just sharing iPhone. What are you talking about? Hey guys, I'm Matt.
I'm Garrett.
Welcome back to Matt and Garrett Take the Movies, and I know it's a little bit belated, but we're going to be talking about Mortal Kombat.
Is it belated? It's on
HBO Max.
Max till, what, the 23rd, I think, of this month.
It's so not bad.
Still have time to watch it.
You know, despite the fact that it's on HBO Max, there was still, like, a good turnout at the theater that we went to
for the first showing.
It was packed.
All the showings I went to, except for you and Bree and the one with Chris, there was one there, but... Other than I've seen the film four times, twice in one day, and I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Oh yeah, it's good. We'll get into that now. So first, I just want to address, like, it seems so divisive that people either, like, online, they like the 95 one, or they like this one, and they can't like both.
Yeah, I've seen all over the places, and shockingly from a lot of people that I thought would like this one, are just saying that they'd rather watch the 95 one, Annihilation, Mortal Kombat Conquest, is better than this one. Which, I'm sorry, you're just... I can understand if you didn't like this one, but saying that it is that a film that came out in 95 that didn't have much to do with the Mortal Kombat at all, and this one gives you pretty much what you would want out of a Mortal Kombat, where the 95 one leaves you, like... empty inside after you're done watching it.
Really?
That's yeah.
How you feel about it?
It's a good film, but it's just like Mortal Kombat film. Like, I guess this one make like I thought everyone would like it because it's literally what we've all wanted for years. Whether it be you a fan of the films, the video games, or combined, like to me, it's perfect. And I don't know if it's because I watched 616 Entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
On YouTube, he did like a whole fucking complete history of Mortal Kombat, like everything up until like X. So I like going into that was watching that, and so like to me, even though I never played the games, watching that like little documentary or series like sped me up really quick to the point where I was like, they're doing that from the video games, they're doing that, they're doing like when I forget his name, but he's the dude that has the fucking sledgehammer. I was like, oh, man, Rayco. They're going back to, like, the, I think it was the fourth one or the fifth one when they brought in, like, weapons implement into the system that mm-hmm. you could use weapons. They did in one of the games where you could, like, break someone's arm and then they would fix it and you would go back to fighting. So, like, I just don't understand. And I guess it's kind of because people are saying they didn't like the sets. The story didn't make sense, which is, like, I get that and Cole Young. But, I mean, it was still enjoyable.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, like, those are the major things that I can really think of off the top of my head. And you could probably count, like, all of them on, like, one hand. Like the things.
There's not much that I don't dislike about this film.
Yeah. I'm a huge fan of both. I watched the 95 one for this occasion just to, like... I've been on, like, a Mortal Kombat
sort of, like... Yeah, me too. I watched a bit of both of them. And they're decent, but then when you start to watch them, you're like... Yeah, they're just... It was a product of its time.
Exactly.
That's what I would call it. And that's what I mean. Like, there was, it just didn't feel like a Mortal Kombat movie. So to me, as a kid when I seen it, I was just like, I just felt empty. And I was just like, what? It was good. But it's just like, where's the fucking balls to the walls action? Where's the blood? There was none of that. Even for a PG-13 film, there was barely any blood that I can remember in that film.
Yeah, you're right.
But I do like the Goro in that. I do like Johnny Cage. I do like the costumes for Scorpion and Sub-Zero because they're simple. And, you know, in this one, they tried to make it, like over-the-top grand, like a nice costume design. I just like the simple ones. I'll agree with that. Like,
I thought they tried to make it more realistic.
Yeah, with, like, the Chinese, like, samurai. Japanese, yeah, like samurai.
Because if you have two different rival... plans, why would they dress the exact same, just with
and
different colors?
That's another thing with this film. It's a book. It opens and it closes with Sub-Zero and Scorpion fighting. That's how it opens and ends. And then in the middle is how the best way I could describe the plot is just a setup for more films in the series.
For an actual tournament.
Which I like from the get-go. I didn't like about the 95. You're just thrown in there to the tournament right away, and you don't get time to spend with the characters. Oh, yeah. Whereas this film, I can appreciate it because, you know, you're getting a full movie or two. I think they said at this point, they confirmed for like two more sequels. They're trying to do, HBO wants them to do a TV series. So while I think people were pissed about it, I think in time they will grow to like it because we're getting all this stuff out of this one movie. And people are just like, it's just set up film. There was no plot. There was no Mortal Kombat. And it's like, did you not watch the same film? Like, it's a setup film for a reason. Like,
yeah.
And I like that they have a plan. That I told you, I think I told you or someone else when I watched it. It's not like, fuck, we walked out of Mortal Kombat and you know they're going to make a sequel. And they're like, well, what do we do for Mortal Kombat 2? No, they have a fucking plan, which I appreciate. They're kind of doing the Saw route or like the Halloween 2018 where they have something set in motion. And I appreciate that. I like that. I didn't like that they had to just throw in the Mortal Kombat right away. I like that we're leading up to it so that it'll be something awesome when we finally do get it. The only really thing that I didn't like, that I really didn't like, was Cole Young. Where you could clearly tell, like, I was reading that the audience wanted someone that they could relate to.
Mm-hmm.
Why out of all the lore in the Mortal Kombat movies would you pick, or, like, the video games, the fuck would you make someone new that like, because they wanted someone to feel relatable to the newer audience. And I'm like, okay, well, clearly, if you say Mortal Kombat, I feel like the three main people you would get for someone that doesn't fuck with them is Johnny Cage, Scorpion, or Sub-Zero. So why the fuck didn't we have Johnny Cage in this movie? And I get it, they're just leading up to it. But my whole thing is, you can clearly tell that a mix of, at the beginning, I want to say, in the early stages, that it was supposed to be Cole Young, was supposed to be Johnny Cage mixed with all the fucking great dialogue that Kano gets. Because I feel like the way Kano comes off in this film is he's very full of himself. And I'm like,
oh, yeah.
That feels like Johnny Cage. And but I love this version of Kano. I'm like, he just seems a little bit like Johnny Cage. This feels like Johnny Cage lines. Like, and he's always full of himself. So I don't know what happened. You said that they didn't want to have a white fucking male lead in the film, which made no sense because there was more of a, it was more of a, I can't say the word, it was a diverse, there's another word for it, it was a diverse group of actors, you know, it just wasn't all fucking white. I think there was two white people in it, Kano and Sonya Blade. So I'm like,
yeah,
whoa guys, I don't know what fucking movie you were talking about. They're like, I don't know, didn't make sense. I'm just going to move past that. Hopefully we get him in the second one because they set it up. So hopefully that's that.
Yeah.
That's probably the main thing I really didn't like. That and like the whole like when they get the tattoos where they have tattoos and that's how they're chosen instead of like you're just the best of the best. So like.
Exactly.
Like, you know, like you're the Men in Black. We're the best of the best of the best.
Well, they still have to apply for that in Men in Black. But yeah. It's just something that's, like,
yeah, but they, given. Yeah, like, I don't like that. Like, even in MIB, they still go searching out the best people. So, I don't know. I didn't like that. It was kind of bullshit. And it was the symbol of the fucking Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, the dragon.
Yeah. Also, theme song sucks donkey dick. And I don't care what anyone says.
Remixed theme song, which they only play, like, it's fucking once. Fucking
tech, because they knew it was shitty. I was like, why didn't... I knew they released it a few days earlier, but I didn't, like, listen to it. I was like, oh, man, I wonder why they didn't start the movie off with that awesome, like, theme.
Now you know.
And then I watched it at the end. And the end credits are cool, though. It has all the characters in, like, black and red.
Yeah, like, sort of, like, Rorschach looking.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah, like you said, it really feels like the first act of, like, a three-part story because... Like the end of the first Mortal Kombat from 95, it like sets up a sequel right away. As in, because Johnny Cage wasn't in this one, I guess they're okay to have him in the next one.
Yeah, I just don't really know what that was about. But yeah, it's exactly like the 95 one in that way where it's setting. Because I'm pretty sure they had a whole thing set up with that. Because they wanted to do a third one, the second one. But I think this one was done in a more grounded reality. I even like the sets and the cinematography. And I know a lot of people weren't too particularly pleased with them, but there was just a lot of shit shot on location of them, like, walking in the desert, and
there's, like,
Liu Kang,
a
like,
few real sets that they just cycle between, like, you have the fighting place, like, the boxing arena, Raiden's temple, and
I liked Sony's it. It was a lot simpler. It made sense in this universe than in, like, and I think a lot of people were comparing to the sets because they were in the 95 movie. We were in Shang Tsung's, like, fucking, like, castle and shit.
Oh, yeah.
So they're comparing it to that. I'm like, yeah, comparing it to that, not that good. But for what we got, the cinematography was really great. There were just some really great shots all around. The fucking,
like, the silhouette of Liu Kang when you first see him.
Yeah, Shang Tsung's fucking, little hideout thing looks like fucking dog shit. You can just tell
it's Outworld?
It just looks like dog shit. Also, someone pointed out that it's funny that, like, they have two doors opening, but if it rains, like, you have to run to get to those doors. There's just doors there for no fucking reason. Also, I don't know how Goro comes out through the doors, and I don't know how the bridge didn't just fucking break, because it just looks fragile as fuck. Also, another thing that was just weird was the character selection.
They tried to fit so many characters in
it. It just felt, and it felt like all the wrong characters, at least for the bad guys. Like, it just felt like all, like, besides Caval, I would be like, what the fuck is going on here, man? I could have thought of so many other people, but then, like, when you start to think about it in the grand scheme, they have these other movies planned out, so.
Well, I mean, the only people they didn't really include was Johnny Cage, of course, Katana, Baraka.
Which doesn't make sense why they had Melina and they didn't have Katana. They even have her blades setting up in Raiden's temple because they have all the, like, treasures or, like, artifacts from past. So, yeah, that it just didn't make sense why they had didn't have Johnny Cage in, and then they had these villains, which you're like, okay, I've heard of them once or twice.
I don't know. They're all expendable because, you know, they all end up fucking dying in the end.
Yeah, and I don't like that, too. The ending is just kind of bullshit, where it's just like you had these characters killed off just to bring them back because death is just another portal, which just means, hey, guess what, fuckers? We'll see them in the sequel. Yeah. And I guess maybe they did that as killing these people off and then saying that,
like,
at
insurance
in case you don't get another sequel, which at this point it's almost guaranteed because it's made its money back and then some. It made its money back, what, the first day, you said?
Yeah.
So
maybe Kung Lao will come back. Who
Kung
knows?
Pao. Kung Pao.
Hand me a fucking egg roll. Well, like, you know,
your anal,
like,
beads. Yeah.
Yeah. You don't feel like anyone's dead for good. Like,
yeah.
There's no stakes, really,
at
the end of the movie. One thing I do want to say is that it sort of has a Rise of Skywalker effect, where they're trying to do too much, so the pacing is... That's another thing.
I like that, and I don't. I don't like that, because it's going so fast, and the runtime, for me, it's close to 2 hours. It's I think it's like 10 or 15 minutes short.
Yeah.
To me, I think it should have been, like, a little bit over 2 hours. Flesh it out more. We get a little bit of Raiden. Get a little bit of Scorpion, which you really don't get in this film. But
no.
Once again, I know it's bad to keep saying that, but just knowing what we know now, the sequels are to come. There's a TV series. Like, this shit's almost written in stone that we're at least getting a second one. So, knowing that, I give it a little bit leeway, just because knowing that there's more to come. And I mean, I liked it. I think the people who don't like it, I think it just needs time to sit.
Suck a dick.
Or that. I think it's a badass film. You get the fatalities. We didn't talk about that yet, but, like, holy fuck.
Iconic finishers. I mean, you have Liu Kang Scorpion, especially. Like, holy shit.
We get the toasty.
Jax?
No, that was Sub-Zero when he, like, fires. He does. That's the I guess they call it the toasty finisher.
You get
Jax's finisher. Arms getting ripped off. We got the one guy that gets killed by Sub-Zero when he brings all the ice and he's outside the pizza shop. You boop.
Casualties, people.
Yeah, Jax's is really fucked up, I will say. And the way you just see his arms and his reaction, and I love how Sub-Zero is just like, and then he doesn't have arms to block his head, so he just hits his head.
Yeah. Sub-Zero is probably, like, one of the best characters. Joe Taslim plays him.
Beyond.
It's such a great performance. Like you said, there's this one scene that you really like when he crushes the bracelet, and he's just like...
Just he does it like multiple times. He's just like, like, haha, you fucker.
So smug.
Yeah, I loved both of their performances. The beginning of the film, that whole like 7-8 minute intro where it's just like, he yikes.
I could go for like a whole Scorpion and Sub-Zero film.
Movie. And that's what I want to say. They used real lighting at multiple times during that scene. Just real lighting. Like, and I don't know if you know how hard that is to just fucking time. But I appreciate that. That's what I mean. Like, I just didn't understand why people were just shitting on it. Because even... there's just so many things that you can appreciate about this movie. Like, yeah. The dialogue is really great. I know a lot of people didn't like the actors and the acting. But I kind of like that. I don't want no really big names. Like, I know people are throwing out a bunch of big name actors to play Johnny Cage. I really don't want to. I like when they have a cast of no names because then it doesn't over... People were saying, good point with the Ryan Reynolds. It's like, that becomes a Ryan Reynolds film then. That is no longer like a... that. Oh, Ryan Reynolds in that Mortal Kombat movie. It's not Mortal Kombat with Ryan Reynolds. And I don't like that. And that's what happened. That's what I think will happen. I think one of the great names that is being tossed out, me and Rick talked about, WWE star The Miz, looks fucking perfect. And his character on TV is that he plays in WWE is just perfect for it. Mm-hmm. I think he's the best casting. That's who I'd like to see. But yeah, we got a Kung Lao with the fucking hat blade. And yeah, rips that bitch in two. We got Kano ripping fucking reptiles fucking heart. Kano wins the fucking beauty.
I killed the lizard man.
I took you to the retreat.
That's, see, all these characters...
I'll fucking shove that sombrero up your ass and you'll be talking Spanish.
He has the best lines.
He does, and I'm telling you, those lines were meant for Johnny. Like, his part was meant for Johnny Cage. Like, I feel like those one-liners.
Yeah.
And, like, Cole Young, like, they were just like, all right, we'll just make a new character, Cole Young. We'll just give Kano fucking the best line. He is the best character, and I heard some people will find him annoying, which I understand, but... I just think he's like, he steals the show. He really does.
Infinitely better than the 95 version.
Are you Russian? I'm fucked. Do I look in fucking Austrian?
You fucking idiot.
Do I look fucking Russian?
Yeah, let's get into the characters right there. So Kano, as you know, is like the best one. And one critique I have for the 95 Mortal Kombat is that Scorpion and Sub-Zero were like under Shang Tsung's control. So they
and
like
then a lot of people think of that. But that's not the, like, story. They've always been rivals. That film just doesn't make fucking sense in some parts. Guys. Yeah.
Because I guess Sub-Zero was on the good side once in, like, Mortal Kombat 10 when he became Cyber Sub-Zero.
Jesus Christ.
It gets really convoluted. But yeah, they have an actual, like, fleshed out storyline here. And it's only, like you said, the beginning and the end. And then they have, like, some flashbacks
but they're
of hell
with,
like, Hanzo.
Which is pretty cool. They're setting up for something to be really good if we can get it. And I think with the next film, they need to just make it a little bit longer. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, the characters are great. We got Kano, Sonya Blade, which I just love their back and forth.
Oh, yeah. All these characters I prefer to the 95 version, except for Liu Kang. I feel like here... he was really, like, a minor role.
Yeah, when he should have been the bigger part. And then we get Kung Lao. He has a great entrance where he just shows up.
Teleports in.
Yep.
Like, that was unexpected when I first
saw
it. Welcome
back, cousin.
Yeah. I'm glad to see them two, both of them together. But, like, come on. Liu Kang was an asshole in the 95 one. Like,
and
I liked him.
Yeah, and Raiden's an asshole in this one.
He is.
You're not even worthy of fighting. You're not mentally prepared.
You don't even have a
tongue. Yeah. Hey, what about me? What about me? What's my fortune say, Gandalf? What I miss.
And like the 95 Raiden, like he's not really...
I like Christopher Lambert.
He's good, but he only like pops in every now and then. And he like... he's like laughing.
Sorry. There's that one like...
Yeah.
That.
Sorry.
Sorry. But, yeah, so they kind of do Raiden dirty in both of those films.
They can't get him right. I don't know why.
They just can't even give the two characters that don't have the least, that have the least amount of time are Scorpion and Raiden.
Yeah.
But I think they're just holding off, setting up the sequel. And like you said, they had already too much going on as it is. If they added more Scorpion and more Raiden with the time that they had, I think it would have just been, it would have felt a little bit rushed, and then it probably would have tainted it a little bit more. So I'm glad that you get the book open. You got like an 8 or 9 minute scene at the beginning, and then you get a full on like 10-12 minute fight scene, which is badass.
The best part of the movie, yeah, in my opinion. When you hear, like, get over here the first time.
Why does he only say that in English?
It's the only phrase he knows in English. Yeah. And then he talks to Cole in, like, perfect Japanese.
Yeah, I know.
Cole's like,
I like that, though, at the beginning when Bi-Han shows up and he's switching back. And he's like, I don't know what you're saying, but I will kill you.
Yeah.
Nice touch. So we have Jax, Cole Young. And that kind of rounds out them. Then we have Caval. Wreck, I think is his name.
Reiko,
Melina, and then the vampire chick, I can't forget her name, but she's not important because she gets ripped in two.
No.
Goro's in it. They do him dirty. And I do like the CGI on him, but he does look like a Raid Shadow Legends character.
He does.
Also, I call bullshit on that because Raid Shadow Legends stole that look from Mortal Kombat. So if anything...
They just copied themselves.
But yeah, I did notice that. I didn't like the way they did him dirty. They didn't. I wish we'd had him like teleport into like his lair or some shit.
Yeah. To be fair, they did him much worse than the 95 one. He just falls off a cliff. My man's holding onto the edge of a cliff with one hand.
I do like that they did it like animatronics and shit for that one.
And a guy in a suit.
Yeah. I don't know if I mentioned we got Jax, but. The Aang, Caval, and then that's really it for the bad guys besides Shang Tsung and Goro. Shang Tsung does the soul sucking, which is fucking amazing.
It's a lot better than it was.
Kung Lao, yeah.
So I'm making a lot of comparisons because that's really what we have to go off of. I feel like a lot of it was better than the 95. Yeah. And the chemistry within the characters sort of rivals the 95 version because those three.
Yeah, they were really heroes, they had really good chemistry.
They did.
And they have, like, a lot of video game references, like the Flawless Victory.
Harry Potter, Gandalf, fucking, what's that one song?
There's in the scene, at the end scene where Kano and Sonya are fucking fighting, I've seen that they have a friendship fatality, like a, it's a fucking, like, an Easter egg, I think. Or just has her, like, autograph on it, loves Sonya in the background when they're fighting. They have Flawless Victory. They have fucking Liu Kang does his dragon.
He does.
Victory for Kung Lao, I think, or I forgot who he says. There's just great moments. Finish him.
And it sort of has like a fourth wall break where like, you know, you have that one asshole friend who like always spans the same move.
Yeah.
But, like Liu Kang does that with Kang.
Hey, enough of your no Harry Potter shit.
Yeah. Is that the only move you know, mate?
Oh, yeah. I love when he's like, hey, all right. Ah, god damn it. I love the scene where he, this is another thing. They have a thing called the Akana, and that's how they learn their powers, which I thought was stupid. But it gives probably the best non-fighting scene in the whole fucking movie. How about you pass me that egg roll? What's your name? Kung Pao? Kung Lao?
He
you don't understand. He is here to save you. You are here to
You're
save.
Like a delicate bunny rabbit.
God damn it! You don't have real. I love when he's like, "Oh, you can call it real straight, man, with your anal beads." And he's like, "I'll shove that fucking sombrero up your ass." Just start speaking Spanish. Then he just fucking rips out the laser beam. Hopefully give him his metal plate in the second one. I think they are setting it up.
Because he got stabbed.
Like, scratched by a reptile. And as the film goes on, you can just see it getting worse and worse. So hopefully that's how they'll replace part of his face with a metal plate. But yeah, I just had a all-around great time. We took our little brothers to go see it, and we were just having a great fucking time.
It was awesome. People in the audience were loving it, too.
Everyone was loving it. I seen it in regular IMAX and Dolby. And I'd probably say the IMAX was the best, surprisingly. But yeah, I just had a really good time with it. I can't wait to see where it goes. They set up some really good things. They did some not good things, but I think they can improve on it.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm curious to see where they take Cole Young, because is he going to be the main protagonist throughout the rest of the films?
I'd rather see that go to Johnny Cage or Liu Kang. Right. Someone that's not a new character because the new audience. I can't tell you how much I hate that shit. That we have to cater to a new audience. Like, I'm sorry if you don't have enough brains to be like, Google, Mortal Kombat history.
Yeah.
YouTube, Mortal Kombat history. Bing, whatever the fuck you use. Like, it's not that hard to do that. I watched a 3-hour documentary and learned everything I need to know going into that movie just because I knew all the prior knowledge I had to Mortal Kombat, besides playing like 1 through 3 on the Super Nintendo back in the day and being fucking terrible at it, is the movies. And I was like, that doesn't seem like the right approach to go into. I wanted to go in knowing the background of the games. And I just think that's a shitty thing on their part to be like, this audience that is for somehow doesn't know what the fuck Mortal Kombat is. My mom, who's never played video games like that in her life, knows what Mortal Kombat is.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's something that no one fucking knows about. And I think that was a really big unnecessary move in their part. And it's what left a really big bad taste in people's mouth. Because they were like, why? A new character. Just pick out of the fucking 12 or 11 games you have. Just pick someone. Johnny Cage. Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Liu Kang, Raiden are like probably some of the most popular names you would think of.
That's it, right?
To a non-person that doesn't know shit about Mortal Kombat. You're like, Mortal Kombat? Johnny Cage. Sub-Zero, Scorpion, Liu Kang. Or Raiden. Like,
those five.
I don't know what there was, but I'm not going to go on that a little bit more. It's just really shitty that they had to do that for a new audience. Which...
It's weird because in some aspects, I feel like it was tailored to like the older generation who grew up
playing them. Yeah, and then when it cut to Cole, it's like, well, here's for the audience that doesn't know what the fuck's going on. And sometimes I think, yes, okay, you should be able to do that. But then when it's things that has such a big lore and like fucking like history, like Mortal Kombat, I don't think you should really need to cater to people because there's an audience for that. And then you'll get those people, but you shouldn't be focused on the newer people. You should be focused on the people that actually give a shit about the game. And that's where I think they really did with this one, is with Cole Young, the whole fucking, that they weren't just the best of the best fighters in the world, that they had to make this whole new story of fucking
tattoos.
That warriors will rise out from Hanzo Hashi's blood and shit. So, I don't know, but... I just had a good time. I'd probably give it a solid 9.5. I just don't really have too many complaints about it. I've seen it 4 times I know I keep saying that, but it's a testament. It didn't really get boring to me. I had a great time all 4 times I've seen it, or 3 times after I've seen it the first time.
Yeah.
It's enjoyable. There are some things that I don't like, but unlike some other people, I can look past it and forgive it because I knew going into it that they had a plan to set up sequels if it did good. And now they want to do a TV series on HBO, which I think could be really good. And I think would probably be more better for the Mortal Kombat is if you did a hour TV show episodic. I think that would be better for it. But I also see the appeal of the movie. So I think that's why they're going to try and do probably a bit better than Marvel, where they'll have like the TV shows and then they'll have the movies and then they'll just all
coincide.
And that's what I think what they're going for. And it's really good that HBO really wants a TV series. So that shows that they really got got backing behind it. So in all, if you didn't like it, I say, sit on it, come back to it. Maybe you'll like it. Maybe you won't. Hey, that's whatever. You have those older ones. We have this one. Like what you like. Don't be a dick. But I just really enjoyed it. There's not too many things I didn't like. What about you?
I'd say probably like an 8. There were some issues with the pacing. I mean, while it was constantly moving, I feel like that's just because they had so much they were trying to do. And things just sort of like resolved themselves too quickly because the heroes, when you last see them, are getting their asses handed to them. Fucking Kung Lao, the best combatant, dies.
Yeah.
And then they just like, kill everyone immediately. Just because Cole Young decides to find his arcana.
And that's why I kind of feel like this movie was kind of like a play it safe or like a fallback. So in case it bombed, which I don't know why they thought it would have. That's another thing before they're really pushing it with the best fighting movie and the best like of gore and the fatalities, and it was nowhere near that. It was good, but I can think of, like, a whole bunch of other action films, like Raid, John Wick, just a few that come...
Yeah.
Ninja Assassin, which was rated R and way more fucking gorier than this. So I do give it that, and I think that's another part that really, like, let people down, because when you constantly push that for, like, a year, year and a half, at this point, I think now, you're constantly, like, fucking balls to the wall. You're gonna be fucking throwing up with the gore we have in this. Also, did I tell you it's the best fighting movie? It's like the Friday the 13th Part 3 trailer. So, and then in that aspect, I think people were like, it didn't have enough gore. And I'm like, holy fuck, did you see that movie? Also, you're unrealistic, because a lot of you horror fans out there are bitching about this film, but don't really understand. Like, if they gave us the true Mortal Kombat violence, that would equal an NC-17 rating. Which would hence mean you would never fucking get it. It's hard to put shit out on fucking streaming that's NC-17. So, yeah.
And then when the Blu-ray comes out, you have to add the code to get the blood effect.
Yeah, I just wanted to touch on that. I think they really bit themselves in a few spots overall, but I just had a good time.
Yeah, it was good. Definitely better than... I won't say it's better than the 95. I have to let them sit for a while before I can really compare them, like... objectively, because right now I'm more drawn to the newer one just because it's fresh, it's fast, it's great, but I just have to sit with everything, give it some time. But for right now, it's an 8.
Yeah,
I guess 9.5.
Yeah,
so that's an 8.75. That's pretty damn good, which means if you haven't seen it for some goddamn reason,
I mean, hey, ask your friend, ask your other friend's friends to fucking use their subscription, make a fake account, do something.
Hell, go on YouTube.
Yeah, I actually was gonna say that. I just forgot. Actually, don't even do that. Don't even waste your time. Go on YouTube. It has all the best clips on it, and then judge it for yourself from there.
Exactly.
But I think it's definitely a watch. I think it's definitely, you know, someone that has HBO Max at this point. Just use it. Sign in, sign out. I think if you're a fan of Mortal Kombat, I think you should at least check it out.
You'll
and
love it.
Then have your opinion. And while you have the 95, we have this new one. It's just a great time to be a Mortal Kombat fan. Because we're getting Mortal Kombat shit now. Hopefully Friday the 13th will happen soon. So then we can have something to look forward.
God, I just want to keep my hands clean of that franchise for as long as possible. Did you see Mortal Kombat? What do you think? Give a comment below.
Subscribe.
Yeah, while you're at it, like the video.
Yeah, give us two sexy bitches a like. And while you're at it, follow our Instagram right here, where you'll get cool behind-the-scenes promos, fucking skits, schedules, and just general shit of us being dumbasses and dipshits.
As we do.
Hey, who doesn't love that?
No one. All right, guys, that's it for now. I'm Matt.
I'm Garrett.
There is no computer.
And there is no BJ Betty. And just remember, if you need some help with that, call my friend Scorpion, and she can give you, he can give you the toasty finisher for her. And she'll never be in your life again, because she'll be Ash. And then you can piss on it and take a shit. And that's the way she would have wanted it.